That dragon, that's Baldur's, isn't it?
Yes.
And you brought it down to save me?
It was very heroic.
Another name. Gunnar.
Someone who loved the Valkyries enough to do this. I wonder, perhaps the Queen? Was I? Coming north, making a new start. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation. And so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value. A mystic well of knowledge. And we'll pick this up later.
Part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here, with you, makes me feel more grown up. Another name.
Why the arcane runes? Perhaps we're meant to find something in Muspelheim and Niflheim.
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men to their deaths.
True. But these men chose to follow. Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this.
Now, I believe I was just acquainting Odin with my mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushrooms to make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Later.
So Odin gouged out his own eye. Because of the mushrooms you gave him?
Aye. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on. But the day he took my eye, I realized he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him. Called the lesson wisdom and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.
We're not getting in there without a key. The Unity Stone, didn't it? I wanted to fly again.
Yes, that's a terrible pity.
I'm confused. I always heard that Vanya's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth. Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
do we go from here? That's right. We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life, you were honorable, strong-willed, and you inspired loyalty. These are good qualities, aren't they, boy?
Yeah. I couldn't believe how many men followed you here.
I thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end than mine.
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
Why you ever wanted to work for Odin?
Back then, I was young enough to still be ambitious. The Aesir gods were as powerful a force as I'd come across, but they clearly lacked for strategy, focus, and sage counsel. All this could I faithfully provide. And so, a stranger from a far-off island found himself with Odin's ear, trusted as he trusted no one but himself. That kind of power, laddie, I must confess, there are perks.
Yeah, but he's Odin.
I never claim to be perfect, laddie, only clever. And often too clever by half.
So what'd you do to get Odin so mad at you?
You know what? I'll tell this one later.
I can't believe he ate it. So what did you do to get Odin so mad at you?
Gradually, as I grew more to care about people and the world, my job became to contain him, to protect him from himself. By serving peace, I served his interests as well. That's the truth. But he saw it as disloyalty. No longer trusting my motives, but not wishing to part from my brain or tongue, he bound me to a tree and adopted a new pastime of casual torture.
Well, I'm glad we came along to cut off your head.
Aye, lad. Lucky break that was.
Another name.
Atreus, to me!
Ugh!
If I'm not mistaken, we've yet to discuss the tale of the giant Bergelmir.
Oh yeah, I remember his shrine. It looked happier than the other ones, mostly.
And we'll pick this up later.
Last we were in a boat, we had just started the story.
We were just starting the tale of the giant Bergomir. It begins in an ocean of blood.
Finally, a story worth hearing.
If you remember, Ymir, the first giant, was fatally stabbed by Odin. It's in his blood our story starts. Ymir's magical guts poured out in a torrent so violent it threatened to flood all of creation. The Jotnar were unprepared, as the very last of them were washed away in the endless tide. Not just Ymir, but all of giant kind faced extinction. And so would Odin's victory have been complete. But Ymir's kind did not all perish that day. Staying afloat in the hollowed husk of a tree, the frost giant Bergelmir endured, as did his lady wife. For weeks they sailed, until finally they came upon a new land. They called it Jotunheim. And there they would start anew. As father and mother, they would multiply exceedingly, and as king and queen, they worked to make Jotunheim a land where giants would know no master but themselves. Bergelmir never sought revenge for Odin's slaughter. And we'll pick this up later.
Thank you.
Come here. Can you finish that story you started?
We need only conclude the Song of Bergelmir, founder of Jotunheim, who chose love instead of revenge. His vengeance was to live and prosper. He died at peace, a legion of his kin to mourn him. He would ever be known as Bergelmir the Beloved.
Bergelmir the Beloved. Huh. I've never heard a story end that way. Not a true one, anyway.
You do, laddie.
Yourself. Focus.
I'm ready!
It's okay back there.
Come.
Wonder who wrote this.
You fellas sure love to make a racket, don't you?
Better not be fighting with your brother again.
Just because he's gotten a little less annoying over the years doesn't mean I ain't got a customer base of my own to keep happy.
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
Well, you came back here, didn't you?
Fair point.
What does it say?
Sir.
These runes read death inside.
What'll it be? I see. Just wanted... to my eyes.
So, Rock said his friend was born in the ship. Where is the green ring?
Look, if you will, I will be gathering resources for our journey.
You don't want to help him?
No.
Dwarven, but no ring. One of his crew?
Scorch marks. Yeah, along the floor and wall.
Clear. I guess we keep looking.
We?
I'll keep looking.
Lack of ring while looting the body.
Oh.
Ugh!
Find Brock's friend alive, are we?
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. It's another one of those maps.
Attached to the Soul Eater.
Well, we know what happened to Invari now. You can just go tell Brock. How we need to fight it, right?
No. We'll fight it.
But why?
Because you are frightened of it.
Behind you!
You two make quite a formidable duo.
Strong, Atreus. Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement.
Green ring. Dwarvish inscription.
The alchemist. But where's the rest of him?
Ashes, most likely.
The Soul Eater got him. I guess we should bring this back to Brock.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. These runes were written fast. Spells out... Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward was promised.
Focus up, boy!
Need more time?
Done.
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside. And, well, he must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Ferruxi. I'll take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside before he croaked.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pig lips. Supple ones.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
I'll fix whatever you let my brother do to it. See you next, whereas I see you.
Boy.
Odin wants to go where he can't reach. Are you saying he's trying to get to Jotunheim too?
Aye. It ranks among his foremost obsessions.
But that doesn't make any sense to me.
Oh? When did I stop making sense?
You're saying Baldur tracked us down to find the way to Jotunheim. But that was before we knew Jotunheim is where we needed to go. That's crazy.
Except for one thing. You are headed for Jotunheim, so he was right.
I'm so confused.
Well then, clearly you've been listening. I don't know what we'll find when we get to Jotunheim, but we must cover our tracks. These ravens will tell him of the tower's restoration, and we mustn't let our efforts be to hit.
What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal Anvari. Meet me at the Lawnsoother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain it to my... Pull the ring off on Vari's hand at the Velander Mines. Feller was always tampering with souls and dark rituals and matters of the night sea.
Eyes to refract the energy. It was his final failsafe.
You've got eyes like him, Amir.
I've got an eye. One! Odin plucked out my other eye precisely to keep me from traveling. Sorry, lads. Thought that would work.
What did Odin do with your other eye?
He'd have kept it in any of 100 places, I'm afraid.
We've come so far. There has to be a way.
Look, bit of a long shot, but for years I'd see Sindri, sometimes Brock, lurking around in that mountain when Odin came for his visits. Maybe they know something.
Brock and Sindri!
Hey guys, question for you. Anyone know where we can find Mimir's other eye?
Oh. That's... Huh? I'm sorry. As a matter of fact, Odin asked me to... He wanted me to build a... He showed it to me, you see, and I... The coin! Sir, will you excuse me?
Well, that was useless.
You know, it was about that same time that Odin came around looking for me to build a statue with some sort of hidden compartment. Now, that not being a weapon and the Aesir being a bunch of pock-speckled cockers, I too saw fit to decline. But I know we got it built just the same.
What was the statue?
It's that one of Thor out there flashing his sack to the lake.
The statue that the serpent ate.
Sorry about that. Feeling much better.
How are we supposed to look inside the snake?
Inside?
We'd better go see what the world serpent has to say about that. Well, lads, I don't know what lies ahead, but now would be a good time to make sure your gear is ready for us. What's more to the horn? To letting you go into his mouth to look inside.
Ew. Really?
By the by, he's not wild about it either.